inclusive of this or the transfer function is going to be k into s square where 1 plus 0.2 is into 1 plus 0.12s. Since the given expression of the given transfer function is already in the Bode form or the time constant form, the first step will be to directly substitute s is equal to j omega in order to obtain the self-sorting transfer function. So s is substituted as j omega and we get g of j omega is equal to j omega the whole square into 1 plus j 0.2 omega into 1 plus j 0.02 omega. And please note, we can substitute that p is equal to 1. So to begin with the magnitude plot, firstly, we analyze the three terms, that is the derivative term j omega the whole square. Then we have two first order terms in the denominator. So we are going to find the common frequencies and they are 1 by 0.2 which is 5 radians per second and 1 by 0.02 which is 50 radians per second. So next we form the table where the terms are listed in increasing order of the common frequency. Hence, the first term is the derivative term j omega the whole square, which does not have any corner frequency and it contributes a slope of plus 40 decibel per degree. Plus 40, since the term is a derivative term, it contributes a plus 20. Hence, since it is j omega the whole square, the contribution becomes plus 20 into 2, that is plus 40. Since it's the first term, we don't have any change in slope. The second term is 1 by 1 plus j 0.2 omega. Corner frequency, as already found out, is 5 radians per second, and the slope changes minus 20 decibel per degree. Hence, the change in slope becomes the previous plus 40 plus minus 20. So, 40 minus 20, we get the change in slope is 20. The next term, first order term, is 1 by 1 plus j 0.02 omega, which has a corner frequency of 50 radians per second. The slope is minus 20, please note the change, minus 20, and hence the change in slope will be again the previous 20 minus this 20, which is going to be 0. Please note that the change in slope is always found using by adding the previous slope plus the present slope. So that is why here it is plus 40 plus minus 20 and 40 minus 20 will be 20, and in this case it is plus 20 plus minus 20, so 20 minus 20, it became 0. After we found this table, we need to arbitrarily choose a lower frequency value and a higher frequency value. And for this particular question, we have chosen omega L as 0.5 radians per second and omega H is 100 radians per second. And the magnitude is denoted by A, so I am assuming my A is equal to modulus G of G omega in decibel. Now we need to calculate the values of these magnitudes at our four frequencies, that is the lower frequency, first and second corner frequency and the higher frequency. So at omega equal to omega L, we can directly substitute 20 log j omega the whole square, which is our first term with no corner frequency. So 20 log omega square and we get a value as minus 12 dB. At omega equal to omega C1, A is again 20 log j omega the whole square. Omega is being substituted as 5 and we get the magnitude as 28 decibel. Please remember that regarding the procedural steps, whichever is your first term without corner frequency, that particular term will be substituted here, 20 log that particular value, in order to obtain the magnitude at the lower frequency as well as the first corner frequency. The formula always holds will be 20 log g of j omega. At g of j omega, we will be taking the first term which does not have any corner frequency. Now, to find out the corner, the corner frequencies omega c2, we will be adding or taking the earlier gain along with the change in slope. The change in slope is found using the slope from omega c1 to c2 in the log of c2 by c1. So substituting the values, we get it as 40 decibel. And to find the gain at the frequency omega h, the formula is again repeated where you are going to add the gain to omega c2. So you get the value as 48 dB since this term happens to be 0 since the change in slope that is to be taken is for the first term 20 and the second term 0, which is already found in the previous table. So that 20 is substituted here and 0 is substituted here. So this term goes and you get the same for table 7. So these points have been marked as A, B, C and D, where A is minus 12 dB, B is 28 dB, C and D both are 48 dB. So these are the magnitudes corresponding to the frequencies lower, quantum frequency 1, quantum frequency 2 and the higher frequency. Note that once these frequencies or once these gains are marked, we always use a scale, that is it should be straight lines. We join the points using straight lines by scale. Now for the phase plot, we directly take from the expression of g of j omega the phase angle equation. Our g of j omega was j omega the whole square by 1 plus j 0.2 omega into 1 plus j 0.02 omega. Hence the contribution by j omega the whole square will be 180 degree, and for the denominator terms it will be tan inverse 0.2 omega and tan inverse 0.02 omega. Hence the phase plot, the final phase equation will be 180 degree minus tan inverse 0.2 omega minus tan inverse 0.02 omega. We need to substitute or find out the value of this phase angle phi for various values of omega, and that has been tabulated in this table. So 6 points have been considered, and for each value of omega a point has been plotted as E, F, G, H, I, J. So these needs to be joined using a smooth curve, which means it should be a freehand drawing and not using scale. So please note the magnitude plot is always using scale and the phase plot is always a freehand drawing. This particular problem is showing 6 values of readings. You can take any number of values that you wish, but not very minimal, at least the 4 values that we have. Like in this question, you have 4 different frequencies, omega L, omega C1, omega C2 and omega H. So at least those 4 values should be surely taken. Now let's see the final graph. Sorry, before that, as you can see, the question has a subpart, which is, in this case we have taken the K as 1. So they are asking to find the system gain K when the gain crossover frequency is 5 radians per second. So for that, we need to calculate the K, and the gain crossover frequency is already given as 5 radians per second. And at omega equal to 5, we have already found out that the gain is 20 dB. Now if the gain crossover frequency is 5, which means we already know the definition of gain crossover frequency is that the magnitude should be 0. So what happens is that for every point of magnitude plot, we should find out a point and minus 20 dB should be added around it. So this addition of minus 20 dB will shift the plot to downwards, and the corrected magnitude plot has to be drawn, and the magnitude criterion, as we know, is independent of frequency. Hence this magnitude of minus 20 is contributed by the term K. So to find the value of K, we need to equate 20 log K is equal to minus 20 dB, and hence log K will be minus 20 by 20, and K will be, you take the anti-log and you get the value of K as 0.0398. So let's get the final graph. As you can see, this is your x-axis where you have the omega in radians per second. This is similar graph sheet, so as you know, it is a log omega, and in this x-axis we have taken our magnitudes. So as you can see, since we have both the negative as well as positive magnitudes, a scale of 10 dB is taken for each division. Okay, so we have 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 mark, and minus 10 and minus 20 is shown. And as we calculated, the point A was obtained as minus 12 dB, that is being plotted here. Point B was obtained as 28 dB, that is plotted. Point C and point D was obtained as 48 dB. So once I take this A, B, C and D, I use a scale to join these points. Okay. So this becomes my magnitude plot when my K is equal to 1. And for the phase plot, for different values, I have marked my angles. Again, 5 degrees is being shown here. So, again, the points E, F, G, H, I, J, and X. speed of 6 points, so they have been taken, and as you can see, it is a plus hand drawing. And for the second part, for the calculation of K, a minus 28 dB has been subtracted from each of the points. So when you had B as 28, B dash is going to be 0 dB. K you are going to sub again taking 28 down, and both C and D 28 down. So when you had it here, K's value as 0.03 moment has calculated here, your magnitude plot is going to be this one. Before I conclude, I would like to say how the exact value variables are taken. So I have taken, started my omega the frequency value at 0.1. If this is 0.1, please note that in the semi-log sheet, as you can see, the first decay you have starting from here till this. So if this is my 0.1, this is going to be 1 because this completes 1 decay. So this 2 represents here 0.2, this represents 0.3, so my 0.5 will be here. Similarly, if this is 1, the next decay, it is marked 1 here, this is going to be 10. The next decade is 100, and followed by 1000, 10,000, etc. Okay? So each of the value, to find out the in-between value, you need to check this value. So if this is 10, this marking 4 indicates this is 10 into 4, 40. If this is 100, this 3 indicates this is 100 into 3, 300. So if this is my 1000, this 6 is going to indicate 6000.